Hi, in this tutorial today, we would like to see how to get started with EdgeBox-RPI-200. So this is the EdgeBox-RPI-200 industrial edge controller, and this is the pinout label for the multifunction Phoenix connector at the side of the device. So there is one multifunction Phoenix connector, one Ethernet port, two USB 2.0 and HDMI 2.0, and two LED, namely LED 1 and LED 2. The multifunction Phoenix connector at the side is removable. When doing the wiring connection, it can be removed for easier installation, and it can be reinstalled back very easily. And on the side of the device is the label, and the other side of the device, we have the connection for the antenna 1, antenna 2, USB Type-C for console connection, and also a nano SIM port. Please do take note that the USB Type-C port is not for powering up the device. It is only meant for data. Now let's make the connection for the power and the internet. Once the connection is secure, we can power up the device. Next, we shall configure the software. For your information, the EdgeBox-RPI-200 comes with pre-installed with OS. Hence, we will access the device through the VNC viewer. Once we have the access, first we need to install the Node-RED. To do this, open the terminal and paste the following line and follow the steps. And once the installation is done, we start the Node-RED by typing the Node-RED in the terminal. Once the Node-RED started, we need to open the browser and key in the following IP which we have obtained on the terminal window. Now, we are ready to write the program to control the LED. First, we need to drag two inject nodes and also the RPI GPIO out node. Next, we make the wiring between the nodes as shown. Once the wiring is done, next we need to configure the inject node as shown, and make sure to change the message payload as the string for both the inject node. Once we are done with the inject node, next we need to configure the RPI GPIO out node. Make sure that we select the GPIO 21 pin, and also we declare the type as a digital output, and we name it as a LED. So once we are done, we can now click the deploy button. Now we are ready to test the project. By clicking the on and off, we can control the LED. That's all for today. Till we meet in our next tutorial, thank you and bye-bye.